Hello, anyone? Mr. Skyzen here, and welcome to Two More Games. Today, we get soggy with a couple of spooks from a haunted PS1 jam. I really like these things. Starting us off, we rev up our boat and head out to Deep City. How long has it been since I started this journey? I don't know. I was asleep in the back. Feels like weeks, or maybe even months. Yeah, I don't have a great concept of time either, guy. Why did I start this again? It has lost all its purpose. Foghorn? What is this noise? Yeah, I was wondering the same, guy. Sounds a bit like metal creaking? Let's check it out. Yes, let's. Oh, we get a run button. Interact. Cool. Whoa. What is my vision right now? Oh, okay, that's the horizon. I thought the visuals were already weirding out. So welcome to Deep City. It is neither a city nor a deep, but I'm sure we'll get to that. Ooh. Yeah, we're in a rust bucket, aren't we? Whoa. Yeah. Squeaky indeed. Nothing? Alright. So... Hello? Is our boat... It is very tiny. There's not a lot going on. Uh-oh. Cutscene? I can't move. Oh. Hi! I'm sorry, was that a robot hand? Okay. Still rusty, but it's something. More cutscene? Dots. Everything hurts. What was that? And where am I? Well, we got pulled into the ocean. And now there's rails? And roads. Okay, so we're getting like land, sea, and air? Hello? Did I back into my text? Well, I guess I missed plot. Oh no. Now we'll never know the true answer. Am I underwater? It would appear so, what with the bubbles and the water sounds. How is that possible? Maybe you're a fisherman. Is that light? Well, I mean, we do have lamps. There's a red light. Alright. I think I can see a train station. Okay. I see. Oh. That's not right. Shift to sprint. Space to jump. Yep, as is tradition. I think there's an exit to the right. Yeah, I saw it, guy. Okay, well, that's an unexpected monster. We have killer lamps. At least we don't gotta worry about the Mothman being here. Gather supplies, City Hall. Okay then. Today our city drowned, but somehow we didn't. Most electronics don't work either. Well, you are underwater. At least we got some street lights that keep away the darkness. Or live in it. This whole situation is insane. I think we are underwater, but the water itself feels so heavy that swimming seems impossible. Huh. How's that work? At least I'm not alone in this. Maybe I will find out more hints about this situation. Master A. So we are underwater somehow and are too heavy, or the water is heavy and keeps us down. Well, I mean, there are... Like the brine pools, when you go super deep, where some of the salt is heavy enough that it sinks into pools, because of water pressure and all that. They're pretty neat. I don't recommend touching them, though. you'll be unalived very abruptly. There are about 50 people who also drowned in the city. Everybody agreed to gather all rations in the city hall. At least we are not alone. We are not alone. So, is this the lost city of Atlanta, or like, what's the story here? Got decent art going on for this. It feels a little bit more PS2 than PS1, but yeah. Something feels off. I'm sure there were more people at the start of this mess. Maybe someone started killing others to keep supplies high. God, I'm getting paranoid. What are those thoughts? Reasonable? I mean, considering you're living underwater, and I mean living underwater, it's somehow heavy enough to keep you down and yet you're alive, you know. That should raise more questions than anything. I got what were originally my supplies from the city hall while nobody was looking. Apparently, there aren't enough people anymore to guard the city hall. I'm barricading in my garage until help comes. Given our present situation, I don't think help's coming, guy. Ooh, hello, Bubble. My one friend, a bubble. Wait, what's up with the bubbles? Are we in a carbonated ocean? I don't think I trust these lamps, though. Is that flesh blobs or boulders? This is spook game underwater. It could be anything. There are so many entries. It looks like the notes of a madman. Question! Multiple. Primarily. How did he write on paper underwater? I think it's day 87. Or B7. We've been playing a lot of bingo. I haven't left my garage in 3 weeks. I think I'm alone. How can this be? There's a little scribble at the bottom. A giant bang woke me up today and I saw a ship sinking into the city hall. Maybe there are survivors. Well, considering it's a ship sinking, I kinda doubt that. I'm so confused how anything functions in this world. Looks like the whole ground is shaking. Yeah, we got ominous lights. What is happening? Yeah, I don't care. Oh, yeah, that's what I was thinking. Oh, yeah, no. Yeah, no. Yeah, no. Oh, no, no, no. The walls are closing in. Is the entire city a monster? This road's a lot longer than I remember. I want to look back. Oh, no, I don't want to look back anymore. The town is catching up with me. I could use some running assistance. Oh, that sounds incredibly close. Help! Somebody! Give me a scooter! I am too slow for this. Oh, that is like right in my ears. I hope I make this. Oh, city hall, I assume? Oh yeah, there were boulders this way. Sweet freedom. Huh. That was a bit more ominous than I was expecting. What, oh, we're inside. Oh, hi. We're inside building. Boat crashed through the roof, I guess? Am I? You get away from me. Uh-oh. I am too late. Yeah. Still questioning the physics, but I guess after a while, a waterlogged corpse will still sink. Maybe I can salvage my boat. Yeah, I was just gonna say, is this my boat? It's very familiar. So wait. All this happened recently? Or at least this survivor guy? Aw, man, so he was on his way here. And we just missed him. Well, bummer. Wait, so I guess there's no saving you? Are you naked, sir? This is it. My last hope just died. Just a rusty, empty boat. Rusty, empty boat. Did our boat sink after we got down here? Have we been down here for other amounts of time? Oh, so many questions. Darn it all. Moral of the story. Never trust a lamp. I can't I just can't anymore. A game by Felix Krauss. And then the game closes out. Well, that could have gone a bit better for us. Well, instead of all that, let's check in on the Serena Expedition. I hear science is happening there. This one's supposed to be a platformer where, at the very least, we get a proper diving set, so that's gonna be nice. I'm pretty sure we were just naked in the water in the last game. Now onward to a drenched demise.
I remember getting the call vividly. I was trying to finish up for the day, but a stack of paperwork was keeping me late. To be honest, I was also looking for reasons not to go home. My phone rang, answered it, and the director of the Institute was talking, albeit disjointedly, about something that had turned up in a recent survey of the Serena Deep.
Control, this is Sierra Echo 1. Connected to docking walkway. Now leaving the bathysphere.
Copy that.
Hey, neat. We get voice acting in this. It's one of these, though. Overall, everything looks decent. Very PS1-ish. But we ourselves look to be a properly 3D'd thing. Under a filter, perhaps. Same with our, bathysphere. It's kind of roundy, not very polygonal. I mean, it looks nice. It just doesn't look very PS1. Oop. Yeah. We got a proper diving suit.
She described something that showed up in sonar imagery, 200 to 300 meters long, and too regular in shape to be a natural formation. I thought she was getting ahead of herself when she called it a facility, but more detailed scans seem to confirm this.
Yeah, voice acting, everything. This is pretty neat. I have no clue what's going on, but look at us skipping along like this. Whee! And I like the room transitions. You're like going through the walls like that because you think, oh, we're going through the wall, we got the blackout, something's gonna grab us. Ooh, I kind of like the water filter going on right now, the little ripples and all. It's pretty neat. Do we get a view out here? No. Oh, we're on rails here. Okay. Oop, that's the wrong button. I just flipped that switch while standing on it. Hey, cool. But at least I got that going for it with the PS1 style. It was sort of 2.5D, apparently. Get that camera rotation. I guess I needed to go there. See, we don't have free roam.
I'm in a central hall. Seems to be where the living quarters were. There's a number of cells along the wall. No other trace of life here. Seems to have been abandoned. It's odd. The construction looks like it's from the 1980s. 90.
Copy.
Yeah, cool. Odd facility in the ocean suddenly appears and has strange architecture, because we got this giant room, but it's just the walkway spiraling down. And apparently she was talking about cells in the wall. I guess those are containing something. Yeah, this. That little transition right there. It's like, what's gonna be over there? Oh boy! That's a monster. That's a hallway. That's the outside. That's an eyeball. That's not normal. At least I don't think. I don't typically go to the ocean floor.
Sierra Echo 1, this is Control. We're seeing considerable elevation in your heart rate. Is everything okay?
Yes, I'm fine. Could you monitor my external readings for anything out of the ordinary?
Roger.
Oh yeah, we're just peachy, we're just working on our cardio. We're not seeing anything out of the ordinary.
There's no record of any structure of this size having been constructed underwater anywhere. And certainly none at a depth of 10 kilometers below sea level. So who built this thing? When? And why? I've so many questions.
As much as I like the PS1 style games that have been churning out, last couple of years. This one's a little bit off the mark with the model, the character model of the bathysphere, and we got dynamic shadows. Or maybe not dynamic, but we have shadows that actually follow us around. I don't think PS1 did that all that much. And we got this filter. I've seen a lot of PS1 style games do this. This feels kind of weird. very artificial. I think some games back in the day may have done something similar, but this feels a bit too much when games do it, and we are bow high. Hey, we're going fast.
Are you picking up anything unusual in my external reading?
Negative, Sierra Echo 1. We are registering continued elevation in your heart rate and blood pressure, however, which indicates acute emotional distress. We advise caution.
I'm fine. Over and out.
Got that stern voice. I am fine. Yeah, we're kind of picking up pace here. Suddenly we started kind of jogging. How are we moving this fast underwater? Oh, big facility. Interesting with the camera angles, though. And I am noticing some of the texture warping. That much is very PS1. There's another switch below us.
I was chosen to pilot a buffer sphere down to the structure and investigate it. An atmospheric diving suit was obviously necessary at that depth, but I've been working on a new suit that utilized highly sophisticated equipment for underwater surveys. This seemed like the perfect opportunity to test it out.
So it's a test suit, eh? Well, I mean, nothing bad has ever happened with new tech being tested in extreme areas. Definitely no hallucinations or anything like that, no. Whoosh. I do like the sort of moon gravity going on, though. Jumping around's kind of fun in this. So we got two ways. Is this what I just opened up? Oh, another switch.
I'm in what looks like a storage room. Can't tell what the storage is. Still not sure what the purpose of this facility was.
Sierra Echo 1, we recommend returning to the bathysphere. Your vitals are highly erratic and we are concerned for your well-being.
I can't yet. Everything's fine. Over and out.
I wonder if there's alternate endings to this. Like, if I were to just go back right now, would we be fine? Oh. Hey. Oh, off we go then. I take it that'll be the other path that I saw back here. Oh, right there. Oh, and away! Physics in this are interesting. Yet the moon jumps, and yet we can sort of run in that one area. But I'm assuming that was specifically for the spook that happened. Like, oh no, there we are dead. We were here all along. We were the corpse. Yeah, we don't get the ups for that. Gotta go from the steps. Got some interesting ambience going on. Got all that oceanic blooping. We're also getting some metallic bits, and I went the wrong way. Sounds like a fork on a Play-Doh in the distance. At least we don't have any lamp monsters coming after us, so that's a nice improvement. Flip the switch. Okay, we close that. So it's a good thing that I went this way before. Where we going? Going to that door. Yeah, this is a very strange layout. What was this place? I am going the wrong way again. I'm getting myself turned around. Yeah, what's in the crates? So many questions. Although I do kind of hope that this is an actual, like, spookum place, and it is not just in her mind. She got the deep sea madness. She was just out for a swim and got pulled out to sea, and now she's drowning. None of this was real.
Yes, I'm aware of the dangers of a dive to that depth. Of course I am. I've been diving for most of my life. And this didn't seem like something I could pass up. The mystery consumed me. I have to know what it is.
I like the different camera angles we get in this. Yeah, we get some slightly more dynamic lighting in here. Not very fitting of the theme, although I do like lighting. Ooh, another big room. Whoop! God, it's all made of lasers. Well, that was fun. What was that? I was expecting, like, maybe eyeballs or something in the windows. Or a giant mouth down below. Also good.
Sierra Echo 1, this is Control. We order you to immediately withdraw from the facility. Your behavior is jeopardizing your safety.
I have to. I have to find out.
Find out what?
Please,
I really want to turn back to see if we can get an ending for doing so, but I also feel like this is the kind of game, with its simplicity, that we would do nothing. It would just be a dead end. So further in we go! Getting a bit weird in here. Stairway to... Oblivion. Well... Either it was a ghost building, or we were hallucinating.
Everything was black. And then I opened my eyes.
And then everything was white. Well then... I may play it again on my own to see what happens if you turn back around. I am super curious about that. But hey, if you're curious for yourself, links in the description for both of these games if you want to check them out and play for yourself. And again, Haunted PS1 Game Jam recently, so there's a whole bunch of these out there. Overall, both of these very decent experiences. Definitely had a lot of the visuals going on, but again, this one had a few flaws. And, like, the character and the bathysphere design, those felt a bit too new, not very PS1, and some of the lighting. I like dynamic lighting, but if we're trying for authentic PS1, you gotta have more jank in there, set lighting, all that stuff. Deep City was decent overall in design, but, like, plot-wise, it felt like a generic spook game, but I do like that final chase sequence when, oh no, everything is trying to kill me. And props for the unique enemy in that game. Who knew the true terror of the deep was a lamp? But anywho, this has been two more games. I hope you've enjoyed watching. If you did, then give the like button a tap. And if you want to see more like this or more from me, then give the subscribe button a big thumbs up. I will see you all next time, and remember to stay groovy.